Alright everybody, it's Revolver84 here, and today we're gonna get on safari on Metal Gear Solid 5, so let's check it out. So when I say safari, I mean we're literally going out there and we're gonna go hunting some animals. So there's two missions, side ops, 48 and 49, one where you have to hunt down a brown bear, and one where you have to hunt down a legendary ibis. I'm not gonna lie to you, I've got no idea what an ibis is. But that's what we're going to do today. Our mission is to get these two animals captured and back to Mother Base. So let's see what loadouts I want to do here. So this is the loadout I'm going to take to capture the legendary brown bear. So first of all, I've got D-Dog. The reason I've got D-Dog is because he can sniff out other animals and stuff and that, and other guards and things, so he's going to be pretty useful, I think, when it comes to hunting down this legendary bear. My vehicle, I've just got it as the bog standard 4x4 that you get. Zaz S84 four wheel, whatever the hell that means, with a funky little safari sort of colour scheme going on with it. And most importantly, my equipment. So, for your primary, I've just got a shotgun. The Rasp TB SG, just in case something kicks off, especially with a bear. I want to be able to defend myself. But obviously, I do have to capture him alive. So, this is what I'm going to go for. I'm going to go for long range, and I'm going to try and snipe the sword with my M2000 NL. Now, bears decharge, and if they decharge, I've got this, my riot submachine gun. It's still a stunner rather than anything else. So the ideal be is to stun the damn thing so I can get back further and maybe take some more shots with me sniper rifle. I've also got me rocket arm and all, but if it's charging, there's the chances that I'm going to be able to use it slim to nil. But you never know, might come in useful. So you can see me support weapons there. Not particularly interesting other than sleep grenades and the LLG mine. And then your bog standard sort of stuff for your items, but most importantly, I do like my wormhole. So even though I'm not envisioning any need to capture these thing inside, I'll just leave it on there just because. Right, so I've been dropped in. I'll show you where I've dropped in. Just north of the suspected area. Now, it's quite a wide catchment area, but also as well, it's quite rocky. There's a lot of verticality here, so my plan is just to get in the middle of the map first of all and see what's going on, and then from the first of the map I'll probably gun up high, maybe up here or up here, and maybe look down and round about and see if I can see him. I mean, it's very unlikely I'm going to be able to see him from my deployment zone, but let's go and just have a look around for the sake of argument. No. So we'll give a little D-Dog a pat. Grab this resource here because it'd be stupid not to. It's just standing just there. Jump in the car, D-Dog. Good lad. Good boy. Good boy. Right, let's get cracking here. So, whoa! Most random start. Oh, didn't tell me I've lost my car, man. I've lost my car. There's another one that's getting the car. Oh, not a good start disaster. I'm going to have to call another one, aren't I? Going to have to call another one. What a disaster of a start. That's a lot of GMP I'm not going to get back, isn't it? What an absolute disaster. I didn't even realise it was that sheer of a drop. What an amateur mistake. Unbelievable. Disaster. Bad start. How Revolver, give your head a shake, you'd be better than that. Thank you, Mother Base. How then, D-Dog, jump in. Right, let's get cracking here. So, one of the criticisms of Metal Gear Solid 5 is that it has you do these missions in the first place, and not just these legendary missions for these animals, but capturing animals full stop. So they are sort of Metal Gear Solid 5's equivalent of your hidden packages, really, aren't they? That's what they are. They're essentially your hidden packages that you're supposed to gun, run, and find. And you have them in every open world game nowadays, don't you? The idea is to expand longevity of the game or whatever. Make you explore places you wouldn't normally gun. And I get it. But I'm with the camp that it's a bad idea for this game, and I'll tell you for why. It's got absolutely nothing at all to do with anything you're digging. It doesn't make any sense for some top-notch commando type to get out in the middle of nowhere looking for an animal. Like, it doesn't fit in with the story at all. It makes absolutely no difference at all why you would want these animals for at all, because they found a wild animal. Oh, what's this? Oh, we have to check that out. Right. Nice and slowly. So anyway, what I was saying was, you're a specialist commando type of thing, you know, you're a soldier. You're not interested in going to run conserving wildlife and that, man. And especially the idea of having a zoo on Mother Base. It's freaking bizarre. Show me one. Bingo. Show me one base in all of human history which is needed a zoo. Do you know what I mean? It makes no sense. Anyway, right in between the eyes. Ready? Poof. Oh, too easy. Too easy. One shot. Wasn't expecting that. Bye, bear. One down, one again. So, this is side mission 49, capture the Ibarus. I've got no idea what Ibarus looks like. That's where it is on the map. Now, where do I want to select it? Do I want it to go south, or do I want to go north? Let's have a look at the terrain here. So, that's just a long valley, and now for a fact, I remember I've run through it plenty of times. I can't imagine it being there. So let's go north. Let's get cracking here. Okay. So here we are, we've dropped into Africa. Let's get cracking. Now, first of all, there's absolutely loads of bloody wildlife running around. Loads. They all look like goats and stuff and that, like. So I think this is going to be a little bit more difficult to do than the last one, which is really straightforward. I mean, I'm not going to lie to you. I didn't really know what an Ibarus is. I'm guessing it's not this goat. So my strategy is going to be the same. So we'll get to the middle of the map, first of all, and then probably get up somewhere high. So if we'll just say we're here. See, there's a lot going on over here, but that's an encampment. I can't imagine the animal being in there. So we'll head there, first of all. Get the lay of the land here. Right. Howdy, dog. Spit spot. What in here, car? I'm not really geared up for combat, like. Really geared up for combat at all. Didn't know where the hell that car was. Anyway, back to me rant. So I've never known a single military base in all of human history that's needed a zoo in it. Not one. And let's face facts, the guys who are signing up to Diamond Dogs. Wild animal found. The guys that sign up with Diamond Dogs, these aren't your normal guys either. These are hardcore war fanatics. That's the whole point of Outer Heaven. So that was like a never-ending war. Do you know what I mean? It just doesn't make a lot of sense. Like, and what's even worse is these missions here are actual side missions, which is by the by. But also as well, you've got to capture a lot of animals as well to get 100%. Now some of these animals, like gerbils and things and that, you can see them running around and stuff, and you set your little set your little traps or whatever, and that's fine. But then the other animals who are of a similar size, like tortoises, is that right? They aren't even on the map. And then you've got things like dogs and cats and stuff on that who are also listed, but they don't even appear actually on the map. You've got to set your little, small little trap thing out for them, and it'll just see when the trap's got them, and you get your RNG once it's sent back to Mother Base, and it decides what animal you've got. But there's massive inconsistencies between between what animals are on the map and what aren't. So I can't see how 1 minute you can have a rat on the map, which is a really small thing, but then you can't have a cat. It's bizarre, like how they've just cut out whole animals entirely. Whoa! Oh man, get out of the way! This lorry. Just in case that happens again, I'm gonna do something about that. So that's an anti-vehicle mine, that. Some plan to get to the centre of the map's not working out very well. Let's go back to the map here. So, I didn't really want to go and do nay, if I can help it. Because it's crawling with guards, but at the same time, I don't think I can get our ground, like. Try going this way. Would help if I even knew what an ibis is. Is it just a type of goat? Is it a bird? I've got no idea what an ibis is at all. And there's a river here. Am I going to find it run the river like an amphibian or something? Not a clue what an ibis is. So I'm just relying on D-Dog here to spot wildlife, and I'm just going to have to look at it until they fund wildlife. Where have you found wildlife, D-Dog? Oh, that's them stupid goats. Where are you now, bud? So I'll keep going this way. See, what I should do maybe is knock them out so that... If I knock them out, he'll stop reporting them out, won't he? So let's see, that I've only got 19 runs, like. Let's just do it. I feel like some American dentist. This is what it's like, isn't it, hunting? Yeah, you know, I mean, the animals didn't have a clue you were there. They had no chance to defend themselves or out. I've just literally ruined their lives. Well, at least they're alive. That American dentist fella. Killing that lion for absolutely no reason whatsoever, other than to be an absolute douche. I mean, what would the lion ever done to him? Do you know what I mean? Like, why? I get the thrill of maybe he's like going out hunting or whatever and stuff, and that of hunting and stuff and that. And I get it, you know, you go back to nature or whatever and stuff. But did you have to kill it? Do you know what I mean? Like, why can't you just take a photograph of it and leave it be? it's an endangered animal. Do you mean there's not that many animals in the like of that sort of standard in the world? Why did you have to kill it? Do you know what I mean? Here to be a square or whatever. You know, I show you the thrill of hunting it down and finding it and getting that perfect shot. Was that not enough? Did you have to blast brains out? You know what I mean? Wild animal found. Where's the wild animal? Howdy, dog. Where's your wild animal? So I deliberately set this up for 6 o'clock in the morning for the sun. I'd hate to be doing this at night. Wild animal, again? Where? Oh, it's just stupid birds. Oh. Like the look of this. Is this the way I've just come? Oh, someone's coming. Just drove around in a circle. I have just drove around in a circle. I've just drove up there, run there, and back down. What an absolute numpty. Let's get out of here, D-Dog. At least my mine got him. Didn't put Dune for any reason. There's another one on the bridge. It's got to cross the bridge. It's patrolling. Right, so. Ibis. I'm deliberately not gunning on the internet to look up what an ibis is for the challenge of it. I could look one up. Of course you can. In this age, everything's on the freaking internet nowadays. But I remember the joy of realising from Metal Gear Solid 1 what the codex code was on the back of the CD case of Revolver Ocelot. Because there was no casual internet access back then. I remember looking for hours going, what the hell, where's it at? Like, you know, have I missed something? Tracking back out on myself, thinking that the game's bugged and restarting and stuff and that, and going, what's going on here? Not understand at all what the hell's going on. And then that moment, that like, I was sitting on my bed, I looks out, I see the case for the game, I was like, no, can it be? And I walks over to me table, and there it was, Meryl tarting a snake on the back of the case, and it was just like, whoa. No way, because up until then, you hadn't really been engaged with in video games at that sort of level. It was always just like, you know, this is what's in front of you on the screen. Oh, I've come to the zone. I am gonna have to go through them doing here, aren't I? I'm gonna have to do it the long way. Deal with this trap. Oh no! Oh bugger. I'll just extract them, sod it. Oh, I've got some company. I'm not even armed for this. Oh, man. I'm not even carrying anything lethal. I'm on a safari, man, people. I'm on a safari. Wait, to get back into the actual frickin' objective area, I'm gonna have to gun through these guards, aren't I? See if I can get his attention. Nope. Oh, crap. Box of Dean Jack. Nice big punch to the face, I think. Have some. I better knock the nude. Good. Just to get rid of him.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
That'll do. That's you doing your little helmet. I wonder. Do I want to take... Oh, bollocks. Take that gun. Just in case I'll kicks off. 21 naffy rounds, like, that's not gonna do much. But I've gotta get back in the frickin' act, in the objective area, man. Got he? 400 meters away from where it is. So you've got to shoot them in the face. It's the only unprotected area on the bodies. That's what you've got to do. You know how it is, should I just clear that frickin' player suit? There's only frickin' two of them left, you know what I mean? Our dog. Back on the safari wagon here. Right, we're back in the, back in the right area anyway. We've left that outpost behind. And as much as I was wanting to avoid going north to south, right through that enemy base, it looks like I'm going to have to. Wild animal. That better be a freaking bird again. It's a bird! Raven. So we've still got that mind of us, so we'll go and do it here. Four by four, bitches. Right. Whoa. You Nas, I'm nicking that, baby. You Nas, I'm nicking that. It's not just a normal truck, it's an armored one. Definitely having that, lad. Right, Right, now I wanted to avoid digging this. I wanted to avoid cutting through their friggin' base, but really doesn't look like I've got a choice here, does it? There's a mission when you've got to extract, yeah, it is. It's the Indian, right? From there, is that right? I saw some move over there. Might have been a shadow. Anyway, yeah, so I really enjoyed doing that that level, if I'm honest, through there. It's a good layout, do you know what I mean? You've got like the basement and stuff as well, the interior is really nice. There's a couple of different areas of communication device you've got to knock out, you know, like satellites. Hello, Mr. Specialist. Just tag you. In fact, could I take him without being seen? I bet I could. Let's go and extract him. What was that? It was me being cool as Oopman. That's what that was. It was me being Nectar. Oh, they're not alert, are they? They're all alert. Oh, balls. Just what I was wanting to sneak past now. Me Riot SMG's got a friggin' suppressor on, hasn't it? I'm sure it has. Nope. So for 5 heroism, I've walked all these up. That's friggin' great, that. Another specialist there, like. I'm not trying to clear with this friggin' building. I'm after a bastard Ibis, whatever the hell an Ibis is. Keep going. Now down here, if I remember rightly, there's a lot of very thick forest around, really. Maybe the Ibis is in that. Am I thinking of the wrong place? Whoa, what's this? Bingo! Right. So. It's a bird, eh? I want a clear shot at it, though. Side of the bridge, the right. Let's see if I can sneak up on it. Here, birdie. Oh, it's up there. How do I get up there? I've got these freaking helmets trying to hunt us. So even if I did shoot it from the other side of the frickin' bridge, I've still got to get it extracted. So, ideas, people. How do I get here? How on earth do I get up there? What was that? Nothing. I thought I saw a guard there. Oh, hello, this looks promising. This looks promising. Hello, beautiful. Yes! Thank you very much, Ibis. Up you go. You know the days. Read, that's me Metal Gear Solid 5 Safari done for the day. Hope you enjoyed it, my little rant. Let us know what you think. Do you agree? Do you think hunting for animals has its place in Metal Gear Solid 5? Or is it completely out of place? Is the zoo on Mother Base a good thing? Does it show you another way of how far you've progressed in the game? Or is it an absolute waste of time, which breaks from the enjoyment of the story and the realism of the story? Because after all, it is just a video game at the end of the day. Let us know what you think in the comments below. I'd love to find out, like, what you all think. If it's just me being a really awkward stickler for canon. Or if I've got some supporters out there and agree with what I'm saying. All the best. Thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like. Cheers.